الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وما توفيقي واعتمادي واتكالي إلا على الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله ونبيه وخليله عليه أفضل الصلاة وأزكى التسليم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد نسأل الله الرحمة والعافية في ذلك اليوم. Your brothers and sisters, have the taqwa of Allah in your heart. Remember that one day we are leaving this dunya for another life. Remember your grave. Remember as-sirat al-mustaqim. Remember the time when you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ ترجمان. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the tathbeet in this dunya and the hereafter. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. Amma ba'd. فَإِنَّ مِنْ أَفْضَلِ أَيَّامِكُمْ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ فَأَكْثِرُوا عَلَيَّ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ فِيهِ. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. As he advises us to send our salam and blessing to him, especially on the day of Friday. وفيه ساعة لا يسأل الله العبد فيها شيئا إلا أعطاه إياه ما لم يسأل حراما. There is a certain time on Friday. If you ask Allah for anything whatsoever, Allah will grant it for you as long as you don't ask for haram. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us, our loved one, our family, a complete maghfirah this Jum'ah. Complete blessing, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And to write us among the people of the Jannah. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الْفَائِزِينَ وَانْصُرُ الْإِسْلَامُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ اللَّهُمَّ آمِينَ اللَّهُمَّ آمِينَ. The man told his wife to describe him. She said, رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا ظاهر الوضاء أبلج الوجه. I saw a man with a striking appearance. He had a radiant face, a nur will come out of his face. لم تعبه نحلة ولم تزر به سقلة. He is neither big and huge and white, nor he was skinny. وسيم قسيم. It was beautifully made. حسن الخلق. Created nicely. في عينيه دعج. When you look at his eyes, you see the black, so black, and the white, excessively white. وفي أشفاره وطف. His eyelashes were long. وفي صوته صحل. There is a beautiful echo and power in his voice. وفي عنقه سطع. His neck, elegantly beautiful. أزج أخرن. His eyebrows, they were arched but not connected. إن صمت فعليه الوقار أو تكلم سما وعلاه البهاء. When he speaks, dignity will cover him. Whenever he's quiet, dignity will cover him. And when he speaks, it's like overtaking, powerful, commands. أجمل الناس وأبهاهم من بعيد وأحلاهم وَأَحْسَنُهُمْ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ. When you look at him from a distance, it was so handsome. And the closer he gets to you, the more beauty you will see in him. حلم المنطق فصل لا نزر ولا هذر. His words to the point, not boring and too long, and not too short. لا يأس من طول ولا تقتحمه العيون من قصر. He is not intimidating by his height, nor he was short, you look down at him. غصن بين غصنين. He is standing like a branch between two other branches. فهو أنظر الثلاثة منظرا وأحسنهم قدرا. He is the most handsome among the three. له رفقاء يحفون به. He was surrounded with his friends. إن قال أنصتوا له. If he say a word, they will all pay attention and listen to him. وإن أمر تبادروا أمره. And if he asks for anything, it is done and done right away. محشود محفود. He was well served and well surrounded. لا عابس ولا مفند. With all these qualities, he was smiling face and he was humble. هذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is your رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. The old lady, Umm Ma'bad, in her tent in the desert of Arabia, when her husband came and she told him, we were visited by a blessed man, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, and the servant with them, or the guide, and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. They spent almost half an hour or so in that tent with a beautiful story, and she was able to capture the description of Al-Habib Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in this description, we see one part is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Jum'ah that Allah will give us the chance to be drinking from his hawl in the day of judgment. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma. The other part at the end, describing his people, his team, the people around him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is not much you can do about his physical description, but there is something to do about his followers, which is we, me and you, as the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially when his name nowadays all over the news is the most popular name in the world, whether in positive or negative, it is out there. It is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرًا. Your dhikr, your name will stay until the day of judgment, number one, bi-idhnillahi azza wa jal. And I want to just tell you a story about how the sahaba, ridwanullahi alayhim, they used to interact with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What kind of feeling and emotion they used to have around Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the sahaba come to Rasulullah sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, innaka la ahabbu ilayya min nafsi. وَمِنْ أَهْلِي وَمِنْ وَلَدِي. Ya Rasulullah, you are the most beloved person to me. I love you so much, more than my own family, my own self and my own children. وَإِنِّي لَأَكُونُ فِي الْبَيْتِ فَأَذْكُرَكَ. And sometime I'm sitting home and I just remember you, Ya Rasulullah. فَأَذْكُرُكَ فَمَا أَصْبِرَ إِلَّا أَنْ آتِيكَ فَأَنْظُرَ إِلَيْكَ. I cannot sit home. I cannot wait but to come and look at your beautiful face, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is not the issue. It is the other issue with him. He said, فَإِذَا ذَكَرْتُ مَوْتِي وَمَوْتَكَ. I know one day me and you will leave this dunya. We'll pass away. We'll die. عَرِفْتُ أَنَّكَ إِذَا دَخَلْتَ الْجَنَّةِ كُنْتَ مَعَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَأَنِّي إِن دَخَلْتُ الْجَنَّةِ خَشِيتُ أَلَّا أَرَاكَ. And on the day of judgment, when you enter the Jannah, Ya Rasulullah, you'll be with the high ranking, you know, Anbiya and Shuhada and Salihin. And who is this miskin Sahabi? Even if I make it to the Jannah, I'll be somewhere where I'm worried that I will not see you, Ya Rasulullah. فَلَمْ يَرُدَّ عَلَيْهِ شَيْئًا. in this beautiful emotion from this man, showing how much he loves Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet wasn't able to answer him until Jibreel revealed this beautiful ayah: وَمَن يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. What a beautiful company with the Anbiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the Siddiqeen, with the Shuhada, for those who have ta'ah and obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمْ اللَّهَ. We all claim we love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We always, you know, we get so touched when somebody mentions his name, whether in good or bad. But the real love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is, if you really claim that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so follow his Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A call was made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of us, to the mu'mineen throughout the world. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَّسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. Answer the call of the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how you can show your love, your ittiba', your following to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by following his steps alayhi salam. And Allah reminds us that when you answer the call, that is the call of life. You will make yourself alive. You will feel happy. You will enjoy your life by following the commands of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now somebody might ask, where do we start our ta'ah? What kind of ta'ah? What kind of amal? What kind of deeds that I can do to be obedient to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? To be obedient and have ta'ah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, this beautiful Sahabi, he comes to Rasulullah sallam and asks him a very, you know, simple question. Ya Rasulullah, dullani ala amalin idha amina al-abdu bihi dakhal al-jannah. I am looking for amal salih, a ta'a to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Since by doing the ta'a, you will have the pleasure to accompany Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'd like to have that opportunity. I'd like to take that, you know, proposal. So what kind of ta'a, what kind of amal we can do? He said, تُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. You want to enter the Jannah? It's all about iman. You have faith, believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Day of Judgment. Now imagine what might fall in between. Now Abu Dharr, he want to make sure he got it right from Rasulullah. He said, Ya Rasulullah, إِنَّ مَعَ الْإِيمَانِ عَمَلًا. Is our iman supposed to be attached with a amal salih, or just, you know, khalas, I have a clean heart. Oh brother, I don't come to the masjid, but I'm better than those pray in the first line. You know, is that true? Is that, you know, we hear these, you know, words often here and there. Is our iman just in the heart, or something has to be reflected somewhere else? فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Instead, the Prophet ﷺ tell him yes or no. He said, يَرْضَخْ مِمَّا رَزَقَهُ اللَّهُ. The first indication of your iman is your ability to give fi sabilillah. Now, you, in the morning, many of us, we go and check our sugar level, make sure we stay within limit. You know, sometimes we go and take our blood pressure and so on, our cholesterol and so on. There is a lot of limitation in life. If we don't maintain ourselves within these parameters, we're in trouble. We put our health at risk. What about the iman? Can we go to the market and get a meter and plug it to our heart and see how is our iman? So we get imanometer. Rasulullah said, your imanometer is your ability to give. Do you have a problem making sadaqah? Do you have a problem helping the miskeen? Do you have a problem of taking care of the orphans and the widows and the needy? Do you have an issue of supporting your masjid, your school, your organization? You know, that is an indication for each one of us, you know. Each one, I can show you the best of my behaviors, the best of my akhlaq, you know. But really, when it comes to sadaqah, that is the heart where each one of us can check individually. قلت يا رسول الله رأيت إن كان فقيرا لا يجد ما يرضخ به. What if this man is فقير مسكين and cannot afford to give في سبيل الله. He said يأمر بالمعروف وينهى عن المنكر. If you cannot give, you know, there is another way to enter the Jannah. Invest in دعوة. لأن يهدي الله بك رجلا واحد خير لك مما طلعت عليه الشمس. If Allah will give Islam, Iman to one person in your life, it's better than the whole dunya. If you can move forward, inshallah, جزاكم الله خيرا. تفسحوا في المجالس يفسح الله لكم. Make a space for your brother, your sister. Allah in return will make a space for you, رب العالمين. اللهم آمين. He said, يا رسول الله رأيت إن كان عييا لا يستطيع أن يأمر بالمعروف وينهى عن المنكر. What if this person cannot, you know, give دعوة, cannot make أمر المعروف النهي عن المنكر. What can he do? He said, يصنع لأخرق. If you're not equipped, you're not all of you, شيوخ and somebody can share the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, just be a handyman for somebody. Fix something around the house. Fix a flat, do some painting, you know, vacuum the masjid. Just do something with your own hand. Doesn't have to have, you know, a lot of skills to do it. أصنع لأخرق. Somebody is not able to do things, do it for them. He said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهُ رَأَيْتَ إِنْ كَانَ أَخْرَقْ مِنْ أَنْ يَصْنَعَ شَيْئًا. What if this man is really don't have it at all? He cannot tell nobody and he doesn't have any skills. فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يُعِينُ مَغْلُوبًا. If you cannot help others, you cannot make sadaqa, you cannot make amr bil ma'roof, you cannot, you know, do all these things, find somebody who is in need. You know, there's a lot of people have legal issues in this country, right? You know, they need the legal advice. They need somebody to stand by him. They need somebody just to let them feel that, you know, we're not forgetting about you. You still love you, still care about you, even if you're banned by it, even if you're, you know, here and there. Al-Rasul said, look for a maghloob, somebody really in need, you know, not financially, but to give him the moral support. Let them feel that you're standing behind him. And that is your ticket to the Jannah. قلت يا رسول الله أرأيت إن كان لا يستطيع أن يعين مغلوبا. What if this man cannot stand by nobody? And he's so weak. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he saw where this conversation is going. But he still want to help Abu Dhar to enter the Jannah, to have ta'a to Allah and his messenger. قال أما تريد أن يكون في صاحبك من خير. Allahu Akbar. This friend of yours doesn't have any good qualities whatsoever. You know, يمسكوا عن أذى الناس. If you cannot help others, if you cannot be a positive person in your community, if you cannot move your community forward, you know what? You still can do something. Leave people alone. Sometimes the best gift you do to your community is leave them alone. The train is moving. Don't drag it. Don't hold it back. Don't create the noise. Don't pull everybody with you. You don't want to do something? That's fine. That's your personal choice. But don't drag everybody with you. Don't hurt others. Don't talk about others. Don't have ghibah and namima about others. If you cannot be positive, don't be negative. Just leave it alone. Then, قال يا رسول الله أرأيت إن فعل ذلك دخل الجنة. If that person do all these items, will that be sufficient to enter the Jannah and to have the ta'a for Allah and ta'a for Rasulullah sallam? فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, listen to this, ما من مسلم يفعل خصلة من هؤلاء إلا أخذت بيده حتى تدخله الجنة. Any Muslim who practiced any of those items, not all of them, any of those items, that specific amal or good deed will hold your hand and make sure you are delivered to the Jannah. May Allah make us among those, Ya Rabbi. In this beautiful hadith, Rasulullah is giving us a choice that each one of us in the community is a talented person. Each one of us in the Muslim Ummah, we have certain talent, certain power, certain, you know, strength in our life. Each one of us can give to his and her community in that capacity, in the capacity they have. Wallahi, mashallah, many of you are, you know, doctors, many of you are lawyers, many of you are businessmen, many of you are directors and managers and what have you. And we, on a daily basis, make America better. Make corporate America better. If each one of us can use that tool, we are helping outside our masjid and just donate probably a couple of hours a week to our masjid here in our organization, our school, mashallah, upstate, wallah, we will make wonders in our community. Each one of us has a certain talent that we can pay back our community بإذن الله. And that's the message of Rasulullah, the ta'a to Allah, and the ta'a of Rasulullah, that each one of us will be able to do something that collectively we can, inshallah, enter the Jannah together بإذن الله عزّ وجل. Now there is a lot of options of a'mal salihah, a lot of options of good deeds to demonstrate our love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's not enough just to know the option, but to go after it. You know the famous story, you know, when we were kids, we learned from our mashayikh that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with the sahaba al-kiram, he told them, يَدْخُلَ مِنْ أُمَّةِ الْجَنَّةِ 70,000 بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. 70,000 of my ummah will enter the Jannah without hisab, without any question. In another narration, with each thousand, there's 70,000 too. So this Sahabi Ukasha said, Ya Rasulullah, ud'u Allah an akuna minhu. Would you please, Ya Rasulullah, make dua that I will be among those special 70,000 people will enter the Jannah without any question? He said, anta minhum, you're one of them. Now the Sahabi next door, next to him, you know, he got excited, you know. Ukasha, just the dua, he's in among the people of the Jannah. Ya Rasulullah, how about if you make dua for me? He says, Sabaqaka Ukasha. Ukasha was ahead of you. A fraction of a second, one entered the Jannah, the other one was in the waiting list. Do not accept to be on the waiting list when it comes to Amal Saleh. We need to look for Amal. It has to be, you know, from within ourselves, that each one of us, we will look for amal salih in our life. When you and me drive to our work for 30, 40 hours, you know, in this town, mashallah, a lot of traffic around you. You spend hours on the highways. What is it we're using our time? This is the in-between time. Are we using it for the ta'a of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we listening to the Quran? Are we listening to a hadith? Are we listening to a lecture? Am I making tasbih? Am I making my morning dua and evening dua and so on? If we can utilize this time, we'll do a lot بإذن الله عز وجل. So competition, musabaqa, musara al a'mal salihah, it is among the essence of the love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then first, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Prophet alayhi salam was, you know, walking at night, he checked on the Muslim ummah. At night he was walking with Umar and Abu Bakr, and they overheard Abdullah bin Mas'ud reciting the Quran in his Qiyam al-Layl. And the Prophet ﷺ, when he made sujood, he said, Sal ta'ta, ask, Allah will give you. Of course, Abdullah did not hear him, he was inside the house. But he was talking, addressing Abu Bakr and Umar. As they were leaving, the Prophet ﷺ said, Man sarrahu an yasma'a al-Quran ghaddan tariyan كما أنزل على محمد فليسمعه من ابن أم عبد اللهم صل على سيدنا. He said, if any one of you wish and love to hear the Quran as fresh as it was revealed, and it's always fresh, as it was revealed to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, you better hear it from ابن أم عبد, from Abdullah bin Mas'ud. And they left. Everybody supposedly went to sleep. Now Umar, he said, فأدلجتُ. Adlajtus means before Fajr, I went and knocked on the door of Abdullah bin Mas'ud. Can I help you, brothers? Not even Fajr, what are you doing here? He said, Jibtu ubashuruka bima qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I came with the news that what the Prophet had said about your beautiful voice last night. He said, Sabakaka Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr already told me. If Umar came before Fajr, when did Abu Bakr go? That is that, you know, if we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we need to have certain kind of competition among ourselves for a'mal, you know, ta'a lillahi azza wa jal. And when one of the areas that we as a community, mashallah, beautiful community, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep your unity together, Ya Rabbil Alameen. I ask Allah to give you a bigger place, inshallah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Because our community will double in 2030. And I'm telling you, unless we do certain kind of expansion or something in this facility or somewhere else, this place will not be enough in a few more years. Our kids, mashallah, alhamdulillah, they will grow. They need a school, they need a gym, they need a facility. And that's why you always, you know, have to think of tomorrow. One of the areas that Rasulullah had in his life, he He was a team player. He had all these beautiful qualities like we have heard, you know, but he was a team player. He worked with the Jama'ah. And one time they were traveling and they want to give ikram to Rasulullah. They want to take care of him. So one of the Sahaba said, you know, they brought like a sheep or a goat. He said, Alayya dabhwa, Ya Rasulullah, I will slaughter it for you, slaughter the sheep. The other Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, I will skin it for you. The third one, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm a good cook. I'm going to make the best meal for you. And you would imagine Rasulullah sitting on the chair, enjoying the Sahaba, competing who will serve Rasulullah. Mahfudun mahshud. He was surrounded and will serve. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقَالَ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَعَلَيَّ جَمْعُ الْحَطَبِ. I, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who will make sujood in the day of judgment under the arsh of Allah and make shafa'ah, خَاتَمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَالْمُرْسَلِينَ. The one Allah had forgiven his past and future. I will go and collect the sticks so I can light the fire. If each one of us can have that attitude that I can do something inshallah, I will go and collect the sticks, wallahi, we can do a lot and accomplish a lot for our communities, our society, بإذن الله عز وجل. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين ويا نجاة التائبين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا رب العالمين. I conclude inshallah one more story about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because the more you know about him, the more you will love him. The more you will know about Rasulullah sallam, the more you will follow him. And if people trying to put his name down, we need to make sure we have him in our life. Our kids will learn more, our family will learn more about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When he was building his masjid, he noticed, you know, Ammar radiallahu anhu, he was dusty and he has a lot of dust around him, but he was carrying two bricks. He looked at him and said, Ya Ammar, ala tahmilu kama yahmilu al-nas? Ammar ibn Sumayyah, why don't you carry one brick like anybody else? Why you're, you know, doing more than others? He said, Ya Rasulullah, inni abtahu al-ajr. Ya Rasulullah, I am looking for the reward. وإني أريد أن أحمل حجرا عني وحجرا عنك. You know, I'm carrying two. Why? I want to carry one on Ammar's behalf, on my behalf, and the other one on your behalf, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Said يا ابن سمية للناس أجر ولك أجر. People will have one أجر, one reward, but you will have two rewards. Always don't settle for the small rewards. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the chance to do more than what you're able to do. You know, this masjid, this facility, wallahi, is not by accident. It just not just happened like that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ زَوَالِيَ الْأَرْضِ وَأَنَّ مُلْكَ أُمَّتِي سَيَبْلُغُ مَا زَوَالِي مِنْهَا. Jibreel, before Google Earth come to existence, he brought the whole globe in the front of Rasulullah. He looked at it like this. And he said, Islam and my Ummah will reach to every single place I have seen. Definitely, Muhammad had envisioned this community. And that's why you're here. The challenge is not you're here to pray Jum'ah and pray Isha and leave. The challenge is, can you take this message of Rasulullah to the next generation? Sahaba made their effort. They made all sacrifices for Islam to reach us. Can we make sure our kids, our boys, our girls, our youth are equipped with the faith, with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the akhlaq of al-habib al-Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so they can be the khatib in this masjid. They will be the imams of this masjid. They will be the leaders of our community. That is the investment, my brothers and sisters, we need to do inshallah bi'idhnillahi azza wa jal. If we love Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك يا عزيز يا الله يا كريم. اللهم وحد صفوفنا وأذهب البغض والحسد من قلوبنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والرضا والغنى. اللهم احفظنا واحفظ أبنائنا وبناتنا وأزواجنا ومؤسساتنا من كل سوء يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم من أراد بهم خيرا يا رب العالمين فوفقه لكل خير، ومن أراد بهم شرا وسوءا فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم كل من ساهم في بناء هذا المركز يا رب العالمين وإعمار وخدمة هذه الجالية، اللهم اكتب له بيتا في الجنة، اللهم اكتب لهم بيتا في الجنة، اللهم اكتب لهم مغفرة تامة يا رب العالمين. اللهم وحد صفوفنا وأذهب البغض والحسد من قلوبنا، وصلى اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا رب العالمين. One quick announcement, my brothers and sisters, I came to you from Dallas, Texas. We are expanding our Islamic center. I have all the information on the table, inshallah. If you like to make investment, inshallah, a sadaqah, a donation, behalf your mother, your father, your loved one, for shifa, inshallah, just do your part, inshallah. As Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَعَلَيَّ جَمْعُ الْحَطَرُ. We'd like each one of you just to do a little investment, inshallah, for that project. وَجَزَاكُمْ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا وَأَخْرَ السَّلَامُ.